Hi, it's Kim from Chatterbox Quilts. Today I want to take a look at some quilts and discuss the four things you need to consider when you're trying to decide how to quilt them. And that would be the purpose of the quilt, the style of the quilt, what is the focus, is it the piecing, the applique, or is it going to be the quilting, and what is your skill level. So when I'm looking at this quilt here, I'm wondering, is this going to be an heirloom quilt that I'm going to pass down to the next generation? In this particular case, probably not. So it's not going to merit all kinds of custom work on it. I'm not going to be doing small, dense quilting. I'm not going to be doing ruler work on it. Probably. I could if I wanted to, of course. But it doesn't really merit that if it's not going to be something that's going to be an heirloom quilt. Now, what's the focus of this particular quilt? Well, is it going to be the piecing? There's no applique on it, so obviously that's not going to be the focus. Is it going to be the piecing or is it going to be the quilting? Well, in this case, I've got all this negative space here that I could use to fill in with a motif if I wanted to draw attention to those areas. But I'm thinking, you know, I could accentuate the star. This is kind of a tough one. You could go either way on this particular one. But the one thing I do know is that these fabrics here are quite busy. And there's no point in doing lots of intricate quilting in here or ruler work because you're not going to see it because of the patterns on the fabrics. You'll see it here, but you're not going to see it here as well. So really, it's not going to be worth my time unless I want to just do it to practice, for example, to do a lot of dense quilting in these areas. I'm probably better to keep it simple, maybe just some straight line or wavy line quilting and keep it to that. The style of the quilt, well, of course, it's a modern quilt. So again, I'm probably going to use more modern designs, geometric shapes. I'm probably not going to fill it with feathers or wreaths or things like that because it's not that style of quilt. And of course, what's my skill level? Well, to be quite honest, feathers are not my friend. I am not great at feathers. So I will probably, again, keep it simple because simple is what I'm really good at. All right, let's take a look at another quilt and apply those four areas again to it and see what decisions I would make. This quilt is called One World. It's from a quilt along I co-hosted a few years ago. And you can see this is quite a contrast to the quilt I just showed you. So this one is a wall hang, okay? Obviously, it's not going to be on the bed or anything like that. And what's the focus in this quilt? Well, that's pretty obvious. It's got to be the applique. Look at all the applique work in this particular quilt. What kind of a style is it? Well, it is, I don't know, what would you call it? It's an applique style. It's sort of a modern style, I guess. It's not a Baltimore album kind of quilt or anything like that. It's pretty fresh and modern looking. So when I look at this particular quilt, I want to make sure that the applique is going to be the star. It's going to be the focus here. It's not going to be the quilting I'm doing. What I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be doing some background quilting because what I want to do is I want to push the background back and I want to make the applique pop out. So in this case, I might outline the applique shapes and then do some dense quilting behind. And I might do something as simple as a little scribble stitch, something small. I mean, if I wanted to, I could do different in the background on all of the different blocks, but I would probably more go to doing something the very same on all the sky pieces here and maybe different on the different layers here. But I don't want to get too many different quilting motifs in there because it's a pretty busy quilt already. So I'm going to keep them to simple, small shapes with the hopes that the applique will pop out. And I might be double layering the batting behind this just to give that effect. What is my skill level? Well, you know what? When I look at this, I'm thinking it's something I'm going to have to think about for a while. I obviously haven't quilted it yet. It's still here unquilted because I'm still not at the skill level where I feel really comfortable doing justice to this particular quilt. I may even take it to one of my long arm friends and get them to do it for me. I don't want to ruin it. I put a lot of work into this quilt. All of the applique pieces, it's raw edge applique or fusible web applique, and all of the pieces have been edge stitched down, even to the smallest little pieces in here. So I want to make sure that the quilting really does justice to this quilt. So if there's a quilt that you have put a lot of work into and that's absolutely gorgeous, and you think that your skill level is not really maybe up to quilting that particular quilt, I would suggest you send it out to a long arm quilter and have a really in-depth discussion about your expectations for that particular quilt. Because you would hate to quilt it yourself and look at it and go, you know what? It just didn't turn out quite the way I wanted to. So sometimes if your skill level is not where you think it should be to quilt a particular quilt, sending it out to your favorite long armer is the best solution. I have another quilt for us to take a look at. This final quilt I want to show you is a jelly roll race quilt. So all just 2.5 inch strips sewn together into a big loop and then sewn together and sewn together and so well. If you don't know what a jelly roll race is, check it out on YouTube. There are lots of videos to show you how to make a jelly roll race quilt, and it's very quick and fun to do. This particular one is definitely going to be what you call a utility quilt. I'm going to be using it. It's not going to be passed down. I want to snuggle up with it when I'm watching TV or on the foot of my bed at night even maybe. I love K-facet fabrics, which is what I've used in this. I love the brightness and the vivacity of it, if I can say that, the vibrancy of it. So this is definitely a utility quilt. So I am not going to spend a lot of time quilting it. As a matter of fact, it is already quilted and I didn't spend a lot of time quilting it. And the other thing to notice is that the fabrics in here are super busy. So again, if I had done all kinds of custom quilting, you're never going to see it. So there's no point in doing that. Now, when I say that, I mean you don't have to do that. If you want to, go for it. It's a good way to practice because you won't see any little mistakes that you make because of the busyness of the fabric. But what I did in this one was just large scale quilting motifs. I did some big swirls here. There's some back and forth quilting going on. Just a variety of quilt motifs, but just big. Okay. And the other thing is that with this particular one, being a modern style, I wasn't going to put feathers in it or anything like that, cross hatching, anything that was traditional. I was going to put some modern big scale designs in here, which I did. I wasn't worried about quilting this one myself because I knew my skill level was up to it. I was very confident in all the designs I could create on this quilt. It all went together really well. And because I used big quilt motifs, which suited the modern look of the quilt, it did not take me long to finish this one at all. So this one just needs to have a binding put on it and it's ready to be snuggled in. So I hope you have found this helpful. Keep in mind those 4 points when you are thinking about what quilt motif to put on your particular quilt. You want to think about the purpose of the quilt. What is the focus? Is the focus the quilting you're going to do, or is the focus some feature in the quilt? And in this particular one, there isn't really a focus, I would say. You don't see the quilting because of the busyness of the fabric, and you also don't really see a design in this because it's just strips put together. So that made it really easy. But if you have a traditional style quilt, for example, you want to use traditional quilt motifs on it. And also keep in mind, what is your skill level? What can you actually quilt well? Because I always say it's better to do a simple design well than a complex design poorly. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Be sure to share it with your quilting friends. And if you want more great quilting information and make friends all around the world, you need to join my online membership group. It's called The Quilter's Way, and you can find it at thequiltersway.com.